Philippe, for the introduction and for the famous keyword. And thank you for the organizer for inviting me to this atelier. So it is my first participation to this Paris GP atelier, and so I'm very pleased to be here. So I will try to present you the CADO NFS software. So for those of you who did manage to install it, you can try it during my talk and feel free to send bug reports or comments. No. Okay, so I will start a factorization on my laptop here, on this hopefully it will finish during my talk. So I will factor 80-digit number, which has I've constructed as a product of two large primes. Okay, and on this upper window here, this is a faster machine we have at in the lab. And on this machine, I will factor 100-digit number during my talk. So this is with the same version you have on your laptop. Okay. Okay. So now I will start describing Sage. So I will reuse a slide from a colleague of mine because these slides are very good. So there's no point in rewriting them. So something are a little outdated. So CADO NFS is a very simple software. It can do only one thing, factor an integer. In fact, two things. It can factor an integer or compute a discrete logarithm. It's a software we developed almost 10 years ago. There is a web page where you can download it and see some figures. It's mostly written in C and C++. And it's distributed under the LGPL. On the latest release, so this is outdated, the latest release is 220, the one you have on your machine. Okay. Okay, we have some figures about the code. We have a lot of commits. We have about 300,000 lines of code. Okay, so I will describe the algorithms that are implemented in CADO NFS. So DL is for discrete log, EF is for integer factorization. So on the right, you have different colors. So prod is for code that is implemented and used in production. So this is what you use on your machine. In blue, IMPL, it means the code is implemented but not used in production. And to do is the code we want to implement. Okay, so this is for the first phase for either integer factorization or discrete logarithm. So basically, we use Klein-Jung's algorithm with some improvements by our team in 2005. And for the discrete log, we use that algorithm also. Over GFP for large P only. We only deal with that case. For the factor-based construction, so we use that. So we have a dependency on Magma currently for the discrete log. We use a small script, a small Magma script that implements basically round 2. Okay, so it's planned to replace that by some code in either C, C++, or Python. For collection, so there.
Yeah, I'm lost because we can use it without Magma.
For the integer factorization, yes, you do not need Magma. Okay. Only for the discrete log. So for the sieving, we use a Franke-Klein-Jung algorithm for sieving. And we use a special ECM implementation for small numbers for the cofactorization. And also the sieving is multi-thread. So if you have a computer with several cores, you can save time. And there are several things at work or implemented. So for example, we had an implementation of FFS, but now it's obsolete with a new algorithm for discrete logarithm in a small characteristic. For the filtering, we have several classical algorithms implemented, and mostly this was implemented by Cyril Bouvier. So especially we have the new algorithm from Cyril for the click removal. And so we have this is a work in progress. So the double matrix trick, this is something invented by Klein-Jung again, and it saves a lot of time in the linear algebra. So this is currently implemented by my colleagues. For the linear algebra, we use the Bloch-Wiedemann algorithm, which is an algorithm that can be distributed among several machines. We use MPI and pthreads for the linear algebra. On there are several. So the middle step for Bloch-Wiedemann is also very fast now. Okay, so this is a work in progress, and we'll soon have also a Bloch-Land source implementation. So finally, for the characters and square root steps, we have a CRT-based implementation for the square root, which is implemented but not used in the production. Okay, for the discrete log, the descent is implemented, but we still need some a few steps. But for example, for the descent, we only have parameter files for a few sizes of primes. Okay, among all that, we have some scripts in Python. So for example, for factorization, the main command is k1fs.py. Oops. Okay, so this is what I called here. Oops, I had an error here in that. Okay, so here you see on my laptop, the factorization is currently in the lattice sieving. So you have some indication on the number of relations found so far is about 166,000. And we expect we need this number of relations. And so the script tells you how far you are on the factorization. So it expects in 3 minutes the lattice sieving will be finished. Okay, so the factorization is a client-server model. So you have a server which does the main factorization, and you can connect to several clients that do the lattice sieving or the polynomial selection. So in the two phases, which are CPU intensive, polynomial selection and lattice sieving, we use a client-server model. And the clients connect to the HTTP server to upload on relations. So here, when you work on a single machine, both the client and the server on the same machine, but we use the same model. Okay, so maybe I'll go back to that. I was here. Okay, so we have some comparisons with different software, so I will show you that. Basically, K1FS is faster than Magma and GP up from 80 digits, decimal digits. Then, if you compare to the quadratic sieve in MSieve, which is quite efficient, K1FS is faster up from 85 digits. And the faster quadratic sieve is Yafu. On K1FS wins up from 95 digits. So this is one with just one thread. Okay, maybe I can skip that. So on the web page, we have just updated the timings for CADO NFS 2.2.0. So these are timings this is on a node of a cluster we have with 16 cores. So this is a CPU, the total CPU time, so cumulated of all 16 cores, and this is a real time. So if you want to factor a number of 120 digits, basically, you need 32 hours of CPU time. And you see the speed up is almost optimal, since if you divide by 16, you get almost that. So you can see on this table that so we have made a lot of progress since this last version. For example, RSA 113 is almost twice as fast with the latest version. And especially the real real time is more than twice faster, because we did improve. So some of the steps were not multi-thread in the previous version, and now they are here. And the comparison of Benborough is here. So this is interesting. So I've asked him to update it to the latest version of CADO NFS, but so this is for the previous version. So this is for CADO NFS 2.1.1. So it did compare several tools. So this is the total time of the factorization. It did compare the time of the polynomial selection. So the score of the different polynomials found on the time of the linear algebra. There is no pari here. I guess it would be outside. There is no pari, there is no magma. So it did compare only Yafoo, MSieve, and so Yafoo, it did compare both the quadratic sieve and the number field sieve. So here the red line is MSieve quadratic sieve. So this is a slower. Then the second one is CADO NFS. So this was a previous version. Then this is Yafoo quadratic sieve. The green line is Yafoo number field sieve. And the blue line is MSieve. This is the number field sieve in MSieve. Okay, maybe I will close that. So here you see we have finished the. Oops, maybe I should stop that. You can see we have finished the relation collection, because we have exceeded. We have more than 100% of the expected number of relations. So then we start. So duplicate removal, so we remove duplicate relations. And then we enter the singleton removal here. And we see we have a negative excess. So this is the difference between the number of relations and the number of ideals. So we have not enough relations. So we need to sieve more. So we start more sieving here. Okay, but okay. So the new target is this number of relations. So we should get it very soon. Okay, maybe in the time here.
So I have exactly the same error.
Yes, this is because in the. In the 2.2 version, we have a stupid mistake that Bill told me. So, okay, I will use only 16 threads on this machine.
Well, it's encoded to 16 threads.
Yeah. So oh, it's encoded to 16 threads.
you can type the code to our code.
Yes, maybe I can. Yes, I will show you. I will show you how. Okay, you have to patch this.
But why do you even need to define maximum?
See, stupid programming. I will not tell you who did that. Okay, so I did restart it. So on this machine, we have 56 cores, so it should be much faster. And, okay, so in the meantime here, yes, we are almost done here. So this is 100 digits. This is 80 digits only on my laptop. Okay, so here we are done. So we'll try the filtering again. And hopefully we have enough fluorescence. Oops, no, not yet. So we have to sieve again. So in the meantime, you see here the polynomial selection did finish, and we start the lattice sieving. So who did who is running something on his laptop now? Did you succeed? Okay, good. Okay, so here we are almost done again. Okay, now we are done. So hopefully we have enough fluorescence. Okay, it seems good. So now we start the merging phase. So we'll create a matrix that will be sent to the linear algebra program. Yes, we use GMPU, yes. We use GMP, we use Python, and basically that's all. So here we enter the linear algebra, so the linear algebra is less verbose, so you won't see anything during this phase. And what we plan, maybe in the next version, is to have some progress report during the linear algebra to know where we are and what is the expected finish time of the linear algebra. Okay, so the linear algebra finished. Now we enter the quadratic character, the square root. And since my machine has two threads, so we try two square roots, two dependencies simultaneously. And okay, the first did fail. Hopefully it will find the factors. Okay. So we need 8 dependencies, I guess, to find the factors here. Where is it? Yes. Oh no, even we need 8 dependencies to find the factors. And at the end, you have some statistics about all phases, about the time spent in all phases. So you see, for example, in the polynomial selection, the first phase, which will find some polynomial with small coefficients, the first phase took about 20 seconds. The second phase will try to optimize the root properties of the polynomials, took 45 seconds. Then to create the factor base, so it's very fast. Then we also compute all three relations, so it took 3 seconds. The lattice sieving took altogether about 1,000 seconds. The duplicate removal is quite fast. Okay. Maybe I will go down a little. This is a singleton removal, which took about 6 seconds. The merge took. So the merge is split in two phases. The first took 12 seconds, the second about 2 seconds. And the linear algebra took, so see the CPU time on the real time, because it's also multi-thread, so the real time was about 40 seconds. And so the linear algebra is split in three phases, Krylov, Lingen, and MKSOL. So you have the detailed timings of all phases. And at the end, you get the factors. And so if you set the variable, the environment variable Kado debug, so all the files produced during the factorization will be kept in a temporary directory, so you can go there and see the detail of all phases. So if I go to that directory, so you have plenty of files. And for example, you can see, so in this upload file, you have the output of all phases that use the client-server approach, so polynomial selection and lattice sieving. So for example, you can see this is the result of a sieving process. So you can see the exact command that one send for the sieving. You see dash T2, we use two threads. And you see the, you can see the relations that were produced. So these are relations with A, B on the factorization, on the rational, on the algebraic side. You can see the polynomial that was found. Okay, so you see it used a degree 4 polynomial here. And this is these are the coefficients of the algebraic polynomial on the linear polynomial here. Okay, and you can see several output of the program. Okay, so in the meantime, on the other machine, the factorization of RSA 100 did finish. And you see, oh yes, I forgot to say, at the very end, you see the time, the total CPU and elapsed time used for the entire factorization. So for this factorization, the elapsed time was a little more than 5 minutes on this big machine. Okay. Okay, so if you have any questions.
So why do you, if you run it on a single machine, why do you make multiple processes each running two threads? Why not make one process running n threads?
Good question. We could also run n process with one thread, yeah. But for the lattice sieving, we save some memory between two
yeah,
threads.
You can just say, okay, if that's better than you just put
it on. Yes, but the speed up would not be as good with if you use only one process with n threads, because some threads would wait at some time. It's due to the way we implement things.
I think the main reason that you want to run thread to run a different computer.
No, to communicate using
no, but his question was when you run on only one one machine. But you can control all that with a command line, so. If you want,
just like yeah. A little bit strange.
The default is to use two threads or. Yeah.
Other questions?
Did someone complete a factorization during my talk? Yeah. Yes, oh, you did. Good. Okay.
What are the precise conditions to use it when you try to? Very small numbers, you get
yeah.
A traceback error with
okay.
A small prime divisor.
Okay, so good question. So the exact condition is you need a parameter file. So what we provide some default parameter files up from 60 digits to 60 decimal digits to about a little less than 200 digits. And the parameters are in the subdirectory parameters. So for the factorization, of course, it's factor. And here is, for example, so we also provide a parameter file for 30 digits. So what the main script does, it if you have a number of, say, 28 digits, it will run to the nearest multiple of 5 and use that parameter file. So for 28, it will work, but for 27, it will not work. But you can simply rename that parameter file C30 to C25, and then it will work. And of course, you can adapt those files. So you have different parameters. Okay, so all those are parameters for polynomial selection, as you can guess. So it says that the degree will be 3 for the polynomial selection. These are different parameters for Klein-Jung's algorithm. These are parameters for the sieving. So it says we use large primes of 17 bits. On okay, you have all parameters you can control for your particular factorization. Okay, so this was first generated by hand, and then for the sieving parameters, they were optimized to have the smallest factorization time. So what we did, we did generate for some numbers of 60, 65, and 70, and so on digits. We did generate the best polynomial with K1FS, and then we did optimize the sieving time and optimize the corresponding parameters. So this explains why in the timings on the web page, we did save so much with respect to the previous version. And so this mechanism of optimizing the parameters is available within K1FS, so you can tune for your particular factorization if you want.